families who also instill these values into the players off the field. Let's hear it for your side. At this time, we ask that you remain standing. And please remove your caps as we honor our great country. At this time, we ask that you remain standing and please remove your caps as we honor our great country with the performance of our national anthem. The performance will be by your Saddleback High School Band. Once again, a very special good evening to each and every one of you. It's time for Roadrunner Football! Tonight's contest pits the Cedarsham High School Jaguars against your Saddleback Roadrunners! The Jaguars are coming off a home opener win against Santa Monica, defeating the visiting Vikings 29-0. Your Roadrunners are looking to build off a successful 2015 season when they finished with a record of 6-5 overall, which was good enough for CIF playoffs. Saddleback welcomes back senior running backs Giovanni Estrada and Valentin Perea, who rushed for a combined 1,125 yards and 13 touchdowns last season. Senior Renee Gonzalez leads a strong linebacking corps that is part of a deep front seven on defense. Jonathan DeLeon, a junior, is the team's new starting quarterback. He has a valuable target in Jacob Roa, who caught 7 touchdown passes last season. Now let's get to the starters on offense.
Hello, good evening, and welcome everybody to Sixth High School, where tonight we have the Jaguars taking on, and they're in the away, road uniforms, and they're full whites against the Saddleback Roadrunners in their dress, white shirts and green pants. Home game for the Saddleback Roadrunners. My name is Peter Pigskin Hebda, along with the one, the only, the Professor Knox Wazley. And again, we're here with you on good old Channel 31 SAUSD-TV for another edition of exciting Santa Ana varsity football here, ringing in the 2016 season. Well, we had actually a kickoff, and it was called back for somebody marching off sides. So they will re-kick from the 35-yard line. And we got a bit of a windy night, good weather for football. Cool, but not cold. Now kicking this one off the 35 after the penalty.
Number 53, Lupe Hernandez kicking off.
Luca Hernandez puts a foot into it, and it takes a bounce on the 23, and it bounces out of bounds, and that is a penalty. As the receiving team, of course, can choose to have it re-kicked or the choice of taking it to the 35-yard line. That's been a rule, folks, for about a good 10, 12 years now, something like that.
At least.
And I like that rule because it's a time saver. Most schools will take it at the 35-yard line. That's pretty good field position.
And it is pretty windy tonight, and I've seen different places. I remember it happened in Boulder, Colorado, where I'm from. Got the wind coming down there, they kicked it off, and then they're behind him. So funny things can happen on kickoffs that shouldn't. That was just out of bounds. We have first and 10 Roadrunners at a home game here at Sangerson Stadium.
So
they're going to kick it again.
They're going to have them kick it, so they didn't want to take it to 35.
Keep moving back. Get better field position all the time. Might as well.
Yeah, well, they think maybe they can get it back. They probably have a couple dangerous return guys over there.
And Sam Snead said in golf, if they're going to let me use a tee to hit on par three, heck yes, I'm going to do that. Give me an edge like that, I'll take it every single time. Come on, guys.
So Segerstam, this is actually their second game. This is the first game of the season for Saddleback here at home. Again, they get the gate here tonight. Decent turnout, not huge, but good. And again, you're seeing everybody decked out in white, black, and red in the opposing stands. Kind of unusual outside of maybe the fundamental game against Godinez, where every other year Segerstam fans will be on the other side, but they're on the other side tonight. Kind of rare, but happening tonight. So the deep men come up to about the 17-yard line or so for the return.
Yeah, they should get very good field possession out of this.
Now, Coach Rob Thompson, he's the head coach. He's the boys' AD. He's the girls' AD.
Yeah, we have another kicker now. That is, as the gentleman said, Chris Castillo taking over.
Well, they want to keep this one in bounds.
He pops it. That's a good kick, guys.
Oh. Takes a bounce out of bounds.
That went out of bounds. Also, that if that stopped, that stayed in bounds, it looked like they didn't fall back, had a chance to recover it. I think after the three, it's automatic, though.
Yeah, I think
you're right. I don't think you can keep going back.
Well, I mean, my question is, will they get it actually where the ball went out of bounds, or will they get it at the 35 if they take?
Well, I think it's a choice.
We'll see.
We'll see what they want. They may say do it again.
I think they already want to do it again.
Okay.
So not exactly a stellar start for anybody.
I'm not sure I've seen it with three in a row out of bounds. Actually, two in a row. It's two because the first one was the offside.
Yeah. Well, three penalties in a row, and that's a rare. That may be a first for me too.
And we are already 5 minutes into the game with zero time off the clock.
Huh. That's right. Of course, Segerstam is run heavy. They run their traditional wing tee offense. If team on defense gives them the room to run, they're going to run it and run it and run it all night. Segerstam will run occasional pass on first down to keep them honest, just for fun. But they get the ground game going. If it works for them, they stay with it, and that's nothing different. Coach Tagaloa this year is his first year here as a head coach. And Mike Franca, who was the man who opened this whole program about 10, 11 years ago, I think in 05, school opened up. He moved on, and he remains a teacher. But farther south now, he's in Laguna Hills, and he's now, tonight's his first head coaching contest. At his old alma mater. He played there many years ago. Strong side to left, split receiver, split backfield. This is the Veer offense they like to run, and they go off tackle to the left, and he just kind of gets sent there by a couple guys in white shirts. Not bad. Perea on the run, Valentin Perea, tailback, senior, 5'8", returning starter, weighs 160. Goes forward for about maybe a yard or two. Two yards.
I got a kick out of that. That's basically your Oklahoma 5-2. That's the old 50 defense. You see a lot of 4-4s, 4-3s. They're sitting in a 5-2. Right now it's 4. But they'll walk into a 5-2. Two corners and a couple of safeties.
You'll see a wingback, Jacob Jimenez. That's number 8 on the right side there. When they have a wingback, it's not every time. It's almost always him. We have one receiver to the short side to the left. Second and 8. Give is to the middle man here. He kind of runs into one guy in the legs there on the second side and shifts over for a few more yards. Estrada, he stretches himself across the 45 to about the 44-yard line. Not bad.
A pretty good job at the edge, stopping number 25, kind of backed in. It wasn't very pretty. You're not going to send a picture to Football Digest, but he got the play stopped and strung along to the outside, slowed the play down. Third and 4, 36.
He got clocked there by David Sadia. Sadia plays both ways. At
35.
He's a middle linebacker, senior, 5'11", 200 pounds. We have got third and 5 at the plus 45 for Saddleback. The wingback takes it. He's trying to run an end around there to the left. Not much there. He went down with a hard thud there from behind. Didn't see it coming. They caught him from behind. Maybe got the yard, and that was about it. They have a new quarterback. He's a senior, but he hasn't played quarterback before. And this kid, number 10, Jonathan DeLeon, he's actually a point guard for the varsity basketball team. He's a basketball star here at Saddleback. He's kind of new to football, but he's pretty athletic. And he's the guy that'll be taking the snaps and running the offense this year. But again, they're a run-heavy offense as well, but he's new.
Okay, they're not looking at run formation. They got fourth and five, play came in from the bench. They're not looking. They're got plus field position, the 44. Yeah. They're going for it.
Yeah, if teams have it a little bit further back from that, they usually punt, but inside the 45, anywhere to that, to about the 30, it's not unusual to see him go for it. Puts it up on a wobbly pass. He kind of got hit as he launched it.
Yeah.
Incomplete. Incomplete. Had an intended receiver, number four. Jacob Rowe was the intended receiver. Also plays safety. Jacob's a junior. Incomplete.
White man took a step back. Pretty safe pass, but it was well covered. He had nowhere to go if he caught it. That might have been a no gain probably in that situation. First and 10. Pretty good field position. Their own 44-yard line for the Jaguars. They're going to run a wing T. It's a lot of option stuff, sort of triple, sort of veer, sort of, but basically it's a wing T. Some double wing look in here sometimes. A lot of formations.
Yeah, they mix things up a little bit. Avalos is your third year starter.
Got the edge.
Nice pitch here, nice, some room on that outside lane. He blizzes his way down to about the 50, just past the 50 yard line. Not bad, nice job.
Important first play in the sense they got around the corner. Saddleback was not able to get to either corner when they tried to go outside on Segerstrom. On the first play, on kind of a slow-developing pitch, he made the outside. That's good job luck in the corner.
Sammy Sandoval, 6 yards, gets his guys to midfield. And a little confusion there on the offense. They're discussing things. Avalos, your quarterback.
Okay, double
Marcos.
Wing look. Double wing.
Yep. Gives to the middle man. He looks for room on that left tackle. Off tackle, still on his feet after the first hit and kind of gains yards as he goes down. Goes down about the plus 39-yard line or so. Nice job.
That's the old double wing.
Santa Maria.
The guy at Patuston ran a lot of. The guy at Bloomington, whose name
first
I'll
down.
Think of in a few minutes. That guy set a national scoring record with a run offense. And that's why, because it works. You get that off tackle, you get point of attack, you got the lineman toe-to-toe, foot-to-foot, and they've got a lot of formations here.
First and 10 at the 39.
Right up the middle.
Look out. Down the middle they go, and maybe a yard if that.
They make you think wide and trap you up the middle. That's a good plan all the way around. It's a busy offense, has been for years. I was kidding the coaches earlier. They used to do those long rides, and they got called several times. We were laughing about it. The referees lose track of the ball. When you give that long ride and that option look and pull it out the last minute, sometimes the guy's tackled, and the referees blow the whistle. They almost have to give it up because you end up giving a player two a game away.
Bagley-Anti on the dash there. He got 1 yard of it. Second and 8. 36. Going skyward here. Toss
call.
It wide open. Way out in the seam there. The far side. How about that? Right near the sideline. And Dipsy Doodle moves afterwards. Nice yardage after catch. Yak, yak, yak.
Yep.
My favorite stat. He got about 8 yards after he made the grab.
I guess he did not get the face mask. Interesting. That was the man they were faking to. He put him in motion and went over.
There was nobody around him, Knox.
Nobody around him. They lost track of him. You lose that guy sometimes. Impressive
drive
so far. Opening drive.
They're very efficient on this. I am impressed. First impressions, very nice. A little bit of motion in the backfield there. They give us to the still man to the left of the quarterback, Avalos, and he just kind of, he breaks free. Look out, he's still on his feet. Oh, he bobbles the ball, fumbles it, he coughs it up, and the Saddleback Roadrunners have recovered. And
good
that
play.
Could have come at a better try for them because they were deep in their territory. So how about that? Jarred it loose. Oh, how about that? Number 13 comes up with it for the Roadrunners in green.
They stood him up and went searching and kept digging for the ball. Finally got a pop down.
Fabian Camargo.
Okay, we've had one drive by each side. Saddleback will have the ball first and 10 about the 11-yard line, I believe. 12-yard line. Game just underway, 8:17 left first quarter. No score.
Let's get you the lineman left to right for the Saddleback Roadrunners. Left tackle is Ricardo Sanchez, sophomore. Played freshman football last year. Jose Frias is your left guard. Senior returning starter. Center is David Pedroza. Also plays middle linebacker. He is played last year, but wasn't always a starter. Nice. Not bad. Dante Perea on that play. Not bad. He slides his way down, glides his way down to about the 25-yard line. They're
good
moving the sticks.
Run.
Getting the first down on first down. About a 12-yard gain.
Good hard run. Good blocking at the point of attack. Good hard run.
Joel Martinez, right guard. He's a senior but did not play on this varsity level last year. Joel Martinez, right guard for the Roadrunners. And your right tackle is Fernando Lopez, senior returning starter. And they run two tight ends, mostly Marco Navarrete and also sometimes Jose Farias. Look out, fighting for yards here. He's in the backfield. He's going to get swarmed and smothered. Down he goes, about five or six guys, about six men, about seven guys involved in that stop. Look out.
They're running a five-man line, but they're also blitzing a linebacker almost every time up the middle, usually right on the 0-1 gap, either way, either side. Putting a lot of pressure right up the middle, making the quarterback get out of there.
Adrian Lopez was one of the main perpetrators on the play now, not a big guy. But he was the first to get in here. He is a free side safety, senior and returning starter. Remember him from last year. So Saddleback, they take their time out of the huddles here. That's what they like to do. Rob Thompson, he is in his own offensive coordinator. He's the head coach, offensive coordinator, and AD for both sports, both males and females at the school. He doesn't teach. It's all athletics for him. Nice toss there. Gets sandwiched. Perea, nice job, nice grab. He made sure he got the ball first, but then the white shirts were right upon him. And they made him pay the price. Down he goes, out of bounds at around the 24-yard line. Yeah. So I'm sorry, they had the 20 before. I thought it was a 25. My mistake. But they got 4 yards on that. Not bad. They got they're looking at third down and 12 yards to go. After the penalty. So bringing in the plays. One player bringing it in. One player coming out. And again. Quarterback is
Jonathan DeLeon.
He's a junior, so he's new to football, but he is a good athlete. He's got
big
some moves.
It's taking him a long time to get up there. They're nice back here watching.
Yeah.
Watching.
They about to get the snap off. There's no tight end in. They have three receivers.
Yep,
one step back. Yep. Too much time. Too much time, and that's something that's one of the, in my opinion, one of the more preventable penalties.
Yeah. We saw a lot of it last night, first game of the year. We saw Godinez and Santa Ana.
Yeah.
Santa Ana rolled once they got moving. They went big, 30 or 12, something like that. And we saw this two or three times last night. Big play, but you got to get more organized than that, and that's just practice and discipline. It is on everybody's part, coaches, players, everybody. Yeah, it's tough.
Don't know if you get Sports Illustrated, Knox, but there was a great article in there recently about clock management. It was fantastic.
I'll bet.
About how many teams, so many NFL teams are just piss poor at managing the clock. It was a great article.
Yeah.
Third and 17 from the 17.
Here comes the
DeLeon taking his time at the line here. Then he calls timeout, saw something he didn't like. I was not sure on something. It was a big gap there between the left defensive tackle and the left
end. He was either faking or going with the blitz. He didn't like the look of that.
Yeah.
He just got out of there. And that'll cost him a timeout early.
Yeah, he was uncertain. That comes with 6:03 in the first quarter. We're scoreless midway through the first on this windy evening. Friday, September the 2nd, Labor Day weekend 2016. First week of the season for the home Roadrunners.
Coach Tagaloa was telling me beforehand, their defensive strategy is to put pressure on people, fly to everybody, quick pressure, be everywhere, fly around all over. And that's what they're doing. They're putting a lot of pressure on there. Extra blitzers up the middle, putting five on the line and protecting the corners and pouring it up the middle. And so far it's working.
Yeah, they got some protection there. They got a good offensive line. They always have. They carve out the good yardage for the runners. The good tradition here, even though it's a young school, Seekerson, with how much it's been, not just one dominant runner, but a good stable of runners that down through the last 10 seasons or so that have just had incredible average yards per touch, per rush. We'll see if that can continue under the tutelage of Coach Tagaloa now that Masarenka is gone. But he hasn't changed anything. He says, hey, I run the same offense, same defense, no reason to change. We're the same type of athletes, the same type of guys. I'm sticking with what works, and it's worked for the last number of years. All right, third and 17 from the 17 after the timeout break here. Backs are split, set to the weak side. The non-tight end side. Lofts it, look out, going skyward. Nice spiral pass. Ooh, his guy was too deep, underthrown. Rowe was the intended receiver, and he was kind of well covered, but the pass is just not quite there. Off target, incomplete, hits the ground.
Pretty good coverage. He threw the ball quite a ways downfield. It got on the inside, and the defender had the inside position. And the receiver tried to push him out of the way and get over there and then say it was interference. It wasn't, but I understand. You got to try that. Pass is a little bit to the inside. Not a bad idea. Just go deep like that. That'll be a fun situation now. Again, they brought the pressure up there. They picked up the blitz man, but the guy got from the outside and put pressure on the quarterback from behind.
Roa, the intended receiver there. He's one of the four both-way players for Saddleback. The other ones are the captain, Pedroza, Navarrete, the tight end and defensive end, and also Jacob Jimenez, who plays wide receiver.
Bad snap, just
look
like
out,
last night.
Out of desperation
and
here. He's going to get knocked back for a
he's
safety.
He's at the one. He's going to say he was pushed in.
I don't know. Yeah. Okay, well, wow. That's actually worse because, of course, they're going to take possession if that's the ruling.
First,
Sigerson will.
You say first and 10, they say the 2-yard line. Again, we saw it last night. I went into a local dissertation. I'm going to be known in this county for the guy who talks about long snappers. I respect him immensely. I'll never put him down. It takes incredible courage to do because it is so hard to do.
Yeah.
And there was another example. Several last night, even the snaps to the quarterback, I think looked like he was on a pogo stick trying to catch most of the snaps out of the gun. Big turnover right there.
Big turnover. You could argue that it was better off if they took the safety because they got the first and goal here at the 3. Look out. Stretches
good
that
speed,
out.
Good speed.
Practically untouched. He's in for the touchdown. Number 3, Sam Sandoval. SS, the scat back, is in for the touchdown. And
good blocking out there, too, and it turned it into a pretty much one-on-one match. And the young defender had not much chance against that runner.
Pablo Garcia for Saddleback is injured. Rob Thompson, this is his sixth season, the beginning of his sixth season here at Saddleback. I believe his first season would have been, 12, 13, 14, 15. Yeah, 16. Well, actually, for his first season was 2011. And he came from San Diego, and he began the football program at Rock Academy in northern San Diego County. He still lives down there, and he commutes every day. I asked him in the interview today if he sleeps. He says, very little, with all the responsibilities I have and the distance I have to drive. That's got to be a tough
okay, there's
no
three
good.
Parts to it, though. The snap was decent. The hold, as far as I can tell, was decent. He pulled his leg through. Missed a kick. The snap was okay that time, but it certainly wasn't on that punt, and that's what set up the touchdown. We have 5:43 left in the first quarter. You're at Sigerson. Sigerson leads Saddleback 6-0.
Here early, as you can see, is the Roadrunners in a 6-point deficit, but... You know, they got an interesting team this year. They have a fair amount of returning kids, and they have some talent. And, you know, for a number of seasons, before I think Rob Thompson's first year, they were winless. And for a couple seasons before that, like 08 and 09, they went through a long stretch where they only had like maybe one or two wins over three seasons. So he's gotten them into respectability levels. You know, they made the playoffs a couple seasons ago, played Rancho Alamitos here. Took a lead against him and wound up losing the game by about 12 points, 13 points, but they gave him a game. And Rancho Alamitos either was CIF runner-up and out of their division or the champion that year. And they hung with him. So it's a respectful program, and more kids will want to play football because they realize there's something here at Saddleback. Something here at Saddleback.
I think
he got a hand on it, did it?
I think he got it. Yes, he did.
Yes, they did.
That's
wow.
Why you pooch
How
it.
About
That's
that?
Classic. That one, they can send to the National Magazine.
Yeah, fooled.
Pop it there. The guy tried to back up. It bounced once, and the Sigerson player picked up just before he stepped out of bounds. That is a turnover, and a remarkably, I haven't ever seen that. We know they try it a lot. That one worked perfectly. The guy behind has to play closer. He's got to move up and stop that. Now they've done this. The man has to fall back faster to block it from that one.
A for creativity and play calling, and an A for execution on that one,
oh,
Mr.
Yeah.
Knox.
Very good execution.
First and 10. Marcos Avalos back at the helm. The lefty puts it up. Nice spiral pass. Look out.
I like the call though. Ancient football. After a turnover, go big. Because that's you get it. 60 years ago, exactly. And that was a good play. And also they're gonna have to watch for this from now. They're gonna have to watch that guy. JC is a starter. He's a running back and a cornerback, starts both ways, and inches in left. It's the long snapper. As I said last night, I'll say tonight, you find anybody who can snap the ball. You don't care what position they play. Last night at number 7, a cornerback, he was a long snapper. Tonight, he is. Excellent all-around athlete. You got to find somebody who can do that. Yes, he did.
Pass completed to number 10, Josh Carrera.
A great catch. A great catch coming back. One thing I've noticed already is Sagerson's faster. They're getting to the edge. They can block the edge, and Sagerson and Saddleback's not getting to the edge, getting outside on the run. Sagerstrom is almost every time, at least to some extent. They're just simply faster. And he got past.
Pass completing to number 33.
They say you're supposed to get past one guy by yourself. Well, he got past two, and a couple of others as well. Took three or four of them to bring him down. Fine run. Nice, safe pass, and it looked like it could have been stopped for no gain. Fine run, turned it into a solid gain.
First and 10 from the 15-yard line.
Second down, 1 yard to go.
Check that. Second down, 1 yard to go.
Double wing with two splits. Two wide, double wing. That's cute. I like that. That's Canadian football, folks. That's a penalty. That's another penalty. Two guys in motion. That wasn't a shift. Come on, guys. Oh, and the coach is arguing, and the official is saying, no, it wasn't. I do not understand that. Canadian football, that's one of the famous differences. They had 2 men in motion. Personal foul, face mask on the defense.
Personal foul, face mask.
I do not know why. Maybe there's a ruling that I don't know about. I don't know why 2 men in motion. That wasn't a shift because they didn't set. Why 2 men in motion is not a penalty. But, hey, things happen. And they let him know, and the official didn't call it, said no, and I don't know why. And the Saddleback coach is asking about that, too. This is a Canadian football joke, folks. If they allow rouges, let me know.
Yardage assessed is half the distance to the goal line. It'll be first and goal for the Jaguars.
No. If you kick it out of the end zone, you get a point. As I remember. I may be wrong. I must be wrong. Because they don't seem to have any trouble with that, but I could have sworn that was a penalty. At least it used to be. Yeah, and no blocking on punts.
Look out! Look it up!
Yeah, and you cannot fair catch. At least in the old world, you could not fair catch the ball, a punt, nor could you have any blocking for you. It was a suicide. Yeah, Westby, but it was suicide on the poor guy catching the ball. Yeah, I don't think they don't need to. They do not need to. I think they're trying to just work that into it. They're moving the ball very fine on the ground. They don't need to throw the ball. There's the inside. Oh, good defensive play.
Ball handed off to number 33, Denison Santa Maria. Ball handed off to number 33.
55 made the tackle. He stayed home, and the ball came. They came right back to him. They ran away from him and then came right back.
Yeah.
Good play by him staying home.
David Pedroza with a tackle. Third and goal coming up.
It's the crunch on Santa Maria. So you're looking at a third down.
That's a pretty good play. Yeah. 88 made the play. 88 slowed it down and allowed the play to happen. Good job coming up the old box technique. He got in there quickly, got upfield, blew it up quick.
11, Jacob Jimenez finished him off for the loss. Fourth and goal coming up.
Went down immensely and intensely.
In a pistol look with trips right.
Pass ball is incomplete. Runner's going to take over. Pass ball is incomplete. Runner's going to take over.
I'd rather pay more attention to the yard marker than I do the scoreboard. I often have the scoreboard guys at home.
Yeah, they do. Good defensive stand by Saddleback. They did the job. They held them out of there because that could have turned the game around quite a bit. It's still 138. Yes.
Yeah. The 3 yard drive, you want to call it that, one play off the penalty.
Good play.
Number 22, Valentin Pereira.
Yeah,
and he. Second down and five coming out. Credit number 28.
Gain of five on the play. Second down and five coming out. Credit number 28, Juliana.
He got cracked pretty good.
Injury on the play. Official timeout on the field.
Injury on the play. Official timeout on the field.
Yeah, it looks like a leg thing. Yeah. I thought he got hit by a helmet.
Pad, you get a helmet on the knee, that can be pretty painful.
Well, I'm not sure that's what it was, but whatever happened.
The
official timeout of the field gives us a chance to recognize BSN Sports. Your Saddleback Football Roadrunners would like to thank BSN Sports for sponsoring the team this year with a generous donation. See your game program for BSN advertisement. BSN is your team's trusted supplier for team gear, including our brand new uniform. Our program would like to thank BSN Sports for their generous support.
Valentin Pereira helped off the field. Roadrunners looking at second and five.
Roadrunners looking at second and five.
They're having good success over that right side.
That's enough for a first down. You're going to need your time carry.
Good play by number 40 coming in from behind. That would be
ball handed off to number 24.
I think is that Jordy Perez?
Ball handed off to number 24.
Jordy Perez came in from the backside.
Short gain. Credit number 40, Jordy Perez with
a
tackle.
And he's sure footing at the beginning of that run.
He's playing left defensive end. That's a basic four-man line, but they do walk it into a five most of the time.
Ball's headed up to number 21, Roberto Ayala.
Credit number 44, Christian.
And another thing the Sagers was just loading the box on him, just put man-to-man on the outside. They don't think Saddleback's going to be able to throw on him. And it's going to be tougher and tougher to run because they're just packing the middle. You can see him walking in more and more into a six-man line with two backers. It's basically an eight-man line. Safety and two wides, and just saying, go ahead and throw on us if you want to.
After one quarter of play, the Jaguars 6, Hewitt-Sound.
After one quarter of play, the Jaguars 6, Hewitt-Sound Roadrunners still looking to get on the board.
The Remaker Effect is looking for leaders for Saddleback High School.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Remaker Effect is looking for leaders for Saddleback High School. Noble Franklin 5K and Rock and Roll Street.
Save the date,
April 22nd, 2017 on your calendars. We'll be taking off our leadership team efforts in January. Students should contact Mr. Herbie to sign up to be part of the planning team. Thank you to our 52 Saddleback student staff members for a successful 2016 event, and a special thanks to Eric Lopez, Ariel Gonzalez, and Valentin Pereira for their event leadership last year. Visit www.noble5k.org or facebook.com/noble5k for information.
Start of the second quarter. Roadrunners take the ball at the 32-yard line. It is third down and six to go.
Roadrunners take the ball at the 32-yard line. It is third down and six to go.
8 points to go at the 36-yard line.
Ball's headed off to number 24, Giovanni Estrada, for a gain of three on the
ball's
play.
Headed off to number 24, Giovanni Estrada, for a gain of three on the play.
Andrew McGonna credited with a tackle.
Number 74, Andrew McGonna credited with a tackle.
Oh, there's some good-sized linemen in there. If Saddleback's going to win this, they're going to have to do what they're doing right now. They're going to have to win the line of scrimmage and just root it out. Because I don't think they had the speed to go wide. I'm not sure they can throw the ball that well. They haven't shown it so far. And they're going to have to move the ball like that and just eat the clock up and move it inside and just overpower people. And they're working at it. First down. On a fourth down play, they got three. That's good. Whereas the Sagerstrom's quarterback, this is his third year Sagerstrom quarterback.
David Sevilla with a loss of a yard on the play.
Third down coming up, 10 to go for the first down.
Third down coming up, 10 to go for the first down.
Yeah, he's looking back there. You can see the ref. He's watching carefully. He let him go that time. Good. The man was there. Good route. Good pattern. Good defense as well.
Pass intended for number 4.
Number 32, David Sevilla with a tip.
Jaguars.
Now that was fourth down play. The announcer's wrong.
Fourth down and 10 coming up.
Thank you. Yeah.
Fourth down and 10 coming up for the Roadrunners.
Number 13, Fabian Camargo, back to punt. Timeout on the field. Fabian Camargo, third second timeout of the half.
Timeout on the field. Saddleback calls, third second timeout of the half.
Hey, your Saddleback High School varsity football team meal tonight was sponsored by
Maggiano's Proud Italy, South Coast Plaza. Maggiano's to its guests in 1391. Italian American cuisine to its guests in 1991. Come join us with your family and friends in the tradition of fresh made Italian classics. Maggiano's is located in South Coast Plaza Shopping Center and is open daily from 11 a.m. to 10 p.m.
Another timeout on the field.
Jaguars football team would like to thank both Richard Matthews and John Herpy for their generous donations in support of the 2016 Saddleback High School football team.
They called that one. Well, that one was called by Sagerstrom. I think they lined up in a position. They thought they were going to punt. While we're doing this, let me get to the officials. Mark Andrews, the referee. David Arjas, Bob Nuno, David Haberman, Willie Delgado, the officialing crew. Referee in the white hat, Mark Andrews.
Are on sale until the third quarter.
9:31 to go, 4th and 10.
9:31 to go, 4th and 10.
A good kick for several reasons. It was a good kick. He wasn't too deep. It made it easier for the snapper to get it there. Took a step or two to the right, get that angle there. Kicked it way up in the air, so there couldn't be much return. They didn't even try to catch it and took a good back.
Punting.
And it got a good bounce. That was well done. Surprised him.
Third and three coming up.
He's staying in the game.
Third and three coming up.
He was going to full speed, I think.
Yeah, and he just never saw him. Guy came in low and got him with the ankle. Third and three. They were thinking, the coaches, I think, were thinking the same thing I was for Sagerson. Let's put the ball on the ground and see if we can do it. They did not get a first down. It'll probably be fourth down. Probably have to punt right now. But I think that's what they should be doing, just working on the run. I think they can get this. A good stand by Saddleback. Yeah, good job staying in there. But I think that's what Sagerson's going to have to do. On both sides, you're going to have to run the ball. The only difference is Sagerson can go outside, the other one can't.
Back to return.
Check that, number 8, Jacob Jimenez, back to return.
Penalty, roughing the punter. It was interesting, if you were watching, it was a late, he was kind of surprised, and all of a sudden he took his time, and realized he got to kick it quick. He speeded up, and the guy ran right into him. Referee threw the flag right away, roughing the kicker. So they get a first down out of it that way.
Running into the kicker is the call on the field.
Running into the kicker is the call on the field.
Yeah. It'll be from about the 27 out to at least the 37 and a first down. Yeah. It's interesting. Both teams taking the time. I think both of them are trying to, as they say, shorten the game. They don't want the other team to have it that much, so they take more time on offense. They're not worried about a lot of plays. They're not going to racehorse you. They're not going to Oregon you. They're just going to keep the play in one way, shorten the clock, shorten the game, as take time. And both sides are doing that. Bootleg. Good first down, 11 yards. That was that a good play action out of there on first down. Good safe pattern to the button hook comeback, whatever you want to call that. Curl goes by several names over the years. Good job by the defense.
Third and two coming up.
Number 33 with a carry, Denison Santa Maria.
Number 33 with a carry.
First down.
Denison Santa Maria.
Looks like a gain of three on the play. Penny number 51, Renee Gonzalez.
Looks like a gain of three on the play.
Jaguars pick up the
Penny
first
number 51,
down.
Renee Gonzalez with a tackle. Jaguars pick up the first down. It'll be first and 10 from the 38-yard line.
Yeah. Oops. Double.
Number 20, J.C. Savaris with a carry.
Gain of 10 on the play.
And Enrique Hernandez with a tackle.
Nice. It'll be first and 10.
Number one, Enrique Hernandez with a tackle.
That's that old double wing look with the inside reverse, double inside. Legal procedure. But we had some of those last night.
It'll be a five-yard penalty. Replay first down, first and 15 from the 39-yard line.
Check that
44-yard line.
That's a fumble, folks. No, it was a great defensive rush. He was holding the hand back. He just pushed it off his hand. Good job by the defensive line. Fine job. Good pass rush. The middle of the defensive line for Saddleback's been very good. I've had no problem with that. Once Doug pops up, but the corners have trouble on the edges, and they're getting around the outside, and they haven't been able to take advantage of that so far for Segerstrom. We have 3:50 left in the first half. Segerstrom up 6-0.
Third and a whole long way to go coming up for the Jaguars. Paul's going to be on the 36-yard line.
Ball's going to be on the 36-yard line. 22 yards to go for the first down.
Okay, here we go. Third and about 20. We're doing a little microphone testing up here. look, a screen to the outside. Whacked in the middle. Surprised you hung on to the ball. A very good hit coming across the middle. Tried the screen pass out there, one or two man screen. Was not successful. As I say, we have about 2.5 minutes left in the first half. Sagerson with a 6-0 lead over Saddleback. It is now a punt situation.
Welsh showed the first down. They needed about 22 yards to go for the first down. They only got about three, so they're in punt formation. 2:20 and counting here. So Saddleback will get a shot at getting their hands with their paws
decent
on the ball.
Decent, not great.
He had to reach back a little bit. Oh, but look out. It hit him, but he gets it on the lucky bounce. It bounced right back to him. Return man comes up. And he kind of slams his way into those defenders downfield. About four or five guys involved in the stop there for Sigerson. Nice job by them. They were down there like a terror. How about that? Nice job. But he still got a halfway decent return. Pushes his roadrunners out to about the 22, 23-yard line or so. They have, I think, only one timeout remaining. And they don't have much of a passing in that we've seen so far. So they're probably going to keep it on the ground and see what they can get. And again, it's 6-0 here. Relatively late in the first half. So, again, high school football, you play 12 and a quarters. And Alexis Vega, of course, plays for, he's the fullback. Pretty quick kid for a fullback, too. They try it a little bit. Correa on a little misdirection run there. Gets slammed early after a little bit of. He got knocked down there by Carmona. Christian Carmona. Defensive end, sophomore, only a sophomore. Played, I think, JVs or freshman last year. 6 foot, 235 pounds. That's a big kid for a sophomore, my gosh. And especially for somebody so young, defensive end, he'll probably grow into a few more pounds in the future seasons. So Saddleback not really seemingly making an effort to get out there quickly. Again, the run game is their mainstay here, but again, they only have one timeout to work with. Split backfield, they come out of the veer here. As, again, the down the middle stuff gets a few, but not much, not enough. Estrada, again, he's been a tired guy here tonight, so it's been a number of guys getting touches on the football here tonight out of the backfield. And they haven't had too much penetration, really, down in the middle there. I mean, some, but it hasn't been enough. So he carves out about maybe 4 yards on that as they had no gain on the previous play. And you're looking at,
Make sure you stick around. We got a great halftime show.
Make sure you stick around. We got a great halftime show.
So we're inside 40 seconds here to go. Third and seven from their own 26-yard line after the 4-yard gain again.
39 seconds formation.
Pitches it as he almost was getting hit. Nothing. Pitches it, but nothing there.
And nothing outside. Great pressure up the middle on the blitz. Great pressure on the quarterback. Had to get rid of it a little bit early. And then again, as it has been all night, nothing outside.
He was in the right position for the pitch, but the wave didn't get fooled, and in they came shortly thereafter, and I think they got maybe 1 yard out of that. 1 yard out of that, if that, as...
Yeah, we only have 17 seconds left. 17 seconds left, but Sagerstrom's giving him a chance to kick the ball and have a play. So that's good clock management, by the way.
Yeah,
we were talking about it earlier.
Absolutely. So I don't blame... Avalos has got a good arm, and I wouldn't be surprised if Coach Tagaloa comes out asking him to fire if they get a play or two before the half is out with their offensive squad. And Andrew Magana, who is definitely the biggest, strongest kid on that offensive line and defensive line, he's a both ways player for Sigerson. He was the main perpetrator on that tackle on the previous play. Would not want to meet that big kid in a dark alley on a Friday night. Take care of business one way or the other. All right. So, yep, fourth down, punt formation, fourth and nine. So, of course, they're punting it away. And this kid's got a good leg on him. He can place him, and he can get some good distance,
good snap.
Too.
Snap. Good kick.
Yeah, he's got a
and
good one
And they're just
going to
let it
Very
go.
Very nice. And this guy's put a nice touches on his punt, and he keeps it totally away from any return man. I don't think they put a return man back there. And it goes wild from the 24 to the 23. So 24, 26, and 27. So what's that, 40, 53-yard punt, not bad.
And again, no reception. They got to catch those. It saves you got to catch the ball. Even if it's a fair catch, I don't give you a return. Fair catch everything, but don't let the ball hit and pick up an extra 10, 15 free yards. That's just not good football.
You got time for one play, obviously. There's about 2.7 seconds remaining. And go deep. What the hell? Why not?
Well, I don't think they will.
I would. What do you got to lose? I like seeing that stuff. I wish more coaches would gamble like that, but it'd be kind of fun. Strong side to right. He's going to hand it off to his only single back set man. Down he goes, kind of loses his balance. His knee hits the ground. He's down. That was number 33 with about a gain of one, and that's going to be it. That was Denison Santamaria, and we are at the end of the half in a game that has been kind of sort of pedestrian, you could say, literally and figuratively, Mr. Knox.
Not much in the air. A little bit of Sigerson. Saddleback had very little, if anything, in the air. And both moving the ball, some on the ground, on the inside only for Saddleback, outside some for Sigerson, but not enough.
Yeah.
Still very close game, but can go either way.
Yeah, I think Rob Thompson, again, head coach, offensive coordinator for Saddleback, is just a little leery, maybe having his quarterback put up too many throws here today because he's just new to the position. He's a good athlete, but he's still learning as he's going. He's a senior, but hasn't really played much football before. And he's kind of being, wants to develop him in stages, and he wants to bring him along. So you'll probably see them keep the ball on the ground. And it's good they're only down 6-0 because they can afford to keep the ball on the ground, but they got to do a little bit more with it. If I'm Saddleback, I'd maybe try some more of the outside runs. The inside stuff's gotten a few yards, but not much. And
their outside has been totally ineffective. Now, I think they're going to have to open up the passing game a little bit.
Maybe the short passing game.
But also, both of them, no mistakes. Because this is a close enough game, you make one mistake, and
that's
the other
true team
pops it in. Right now, it's 6-0. One mistake can change the whole game.
But let's give a gold star to this Saddleback defense. They've held twice on two deep drives against the Sigerson Jaguars. So they've done a fine job, and they've kept their offense in a position to be within striking distance at 6-0. My name is Peter Pixenhebda, along with the one, the only Knox, the Professor Wosley. We'll return for the second half. Stay tuned.